Howdy's gamers, welcome back to my Let's Play of Xenoblade Chronicles X, where in the previous video we defeated the boss of this chapter, Goetia. You know, we were introduced to the ganglion, or formally introduced, I guess, technically, because before we the enemies were only known as the prone, but now they're known as ganglion, and yeah, we just defeated those. And now we have to head back to the city. So, yeah. But before we do that, let's go and, there's a couple little treasures we have to, find around here. Okay, wait a minute. I don't really mind running into these guys. This is not that tough, but it just, conserves time. Staggered. I'm not gonna worry about top. Oh man, he stole my. Bam, keep shooting. I'm gonna do that first and then keep shooting. Alright. Because when you blow off appendages from certain monsters. So, like, if you shoot off their tail or something, you can get. Normally, you get more or better pickups than just killing the monster. So yeah. Now, you don't think? Wow, I don't think I have gone through this area before. Whoa, hold up. Yeah, I definitely haven't gone through this area before. Huh. I never noticed this little tunnel here. Huh. That just tells you how big the game is. Alright, let's kill this guy. How, like, this game is so huge that, even after playing 300 hours of this game, I still am finding new things. This part I like, he said. Aw, man, Lau, you're such an awesome character. I don't know, I might cut some flack liking Lau because of something that I won't spoil, but I like him. Like, up until then, I still like Lau. He's an awesome character. Up until... I still like the character, even after that. One point that I won't mention. Stiff hair. Okay. We probably may not be able to do this. We will. So... kind of annoying thing about this game, but also sometimes convenient, is that both, did I not skip this guy already? Or beat this guy? No, I think it just skipped up. I didn't beat him. But, both the gamepad and, if you use a pro controller, both the gamepad and the controller, can be used at the same time. Neither controller is gonna cancel out the other. Like, if I put on the pro controller, I can still use the gamepad if I want. I can just hot swap no matter what. So, like, I got the gamepad set up here. Like, I guess the main reason to have a pro controller and a gamepad. Whoa, you see that? See that little plant right there? That's just kind of. See, here, after playing this game after a while, you notice it started raining. You notice that nearly every single plant that's on the ground, at least, is sprites. So, like, if I spin the camera around, it's like, you're not seeing around the plant. It's showing you the exact, the same exact picture. It's just, it moves with the camera. From far away, It's not noticeable, but when you get real close to it, it's very noticeable. So, I mean, they had to cut some corners for such a big game like this, so I'll forgive them for that. Although, Zelda, I think they do sprites with their grass as well, but they do it in such a way to where there's so much grass in one area that you can barely tell that it's sprite. That if it is a sprite. But anyway, what was I saying? Something about if I was saying something important, maybe I'll probably look back at the recording and just like realize that it was something completely obvious. I'm probably looking at it, and yeah. But anyway, let me get these couple field actions here. I think there's one more, in that tunnel that I never knew was there. Where was that tunnel? It's like over here past the water. Oh, there it is. It's up here. Now, this is in regards to, again, I'm comparing this to Zelda again, but I mean, it's a worthy comparison since they're both very large games on a Nintendo console. One game is like substantially larger than the other, but the other is substantially more, interactive than the other. Let me see. Like, after playing Zelda, you notice this game is virtually, well, let's just say the complete opposite of Zelda as far as interactivity. The only thing you can interact with is the monsters. You can traverse practically the whole landscape you can't climb anything. That's kind of a bummer, but since I'm used to this game, so I know you can't climb anything. But there are certain areas that you can still, because of the jump they give you and just certain clippings they did to they either missed or that they just didn't think about. Or heck, maybe it was planned. You can get to certain points, certain high points that they didn't intend for you to get up to. But anyway, the textures on like the rocks and stuff are noticeably, they're not really great if you compare it to like PS4 Xbox One games, but they are definitely higher than Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild, which is, I guess, one criticism I give Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild is that I wish they went like all out with their stylized graphics, like how for example Wind Waker was such a awesome looking game just because they didn't try to mix the realistic style with the stylized cartoony graphics. They just went full in with full in with all the stylized cartoony graphics. This game, they went all in with the realistic graphics. The only thing that really doesn't look realistic is the anime-esque eyes and stuff, but it all blends in really well. And I guess they had, honestly, I think they worked on this game a lot longer than they did Zelda. Don't quote me on that, but I mean, it just looks, as far as the graphic fidelity. Everything looks a little bit more polished than Zelda does. And the reason I say that I wish Zelda went for more, you know, Breath of the Wild went for a more stylized look is because, if they went for a more stylized look, like it, you know, went more cartoony, you know, because all the characters and all the, you know, weapons and stuff, they look, you know, Wind Waker-esque. You know, they kept the mature, you know, mature-sized Link, but they, you know, they mixed it with the Wind Waker graphics. But the rest of the world, like the traverse, basically just the entire traversable world, the ground, the rocks, not the grass, but like the trees. It's interesting. They mixed a realistic style with a cartoony style, and it works for the most part, except when you look at the mountains and stuff, which is why I wish they went for just a full out stylized look. Like, because this whole game, Xenoblade specifically, this whole game was meant to look like really realistic. The textures don't look, and because you notice little corners they had to cut just to make this game so big, like walking through animals. And, you know, the grass sprites. Oh, also, some of the grass, like, if you move out far enough, which most games do this anyway. Oh, hey. Yeah, I'll talk about that after I'm done killing this guy. Which, oh man, I shouldn't have used a tornado blade. I aggroed that, seaweed over there. Will do. Oh man, he was staggered. Did I topple him? Oh, I got a skill. Okay. Alright. But anyway, I was gonna say, from close up, these trees, you know, they're not sprites, but when, and other games do this too, even PS4 games I've noticed, you know, do this. Some PC games to an extent. You get back far enough, and you see that tree that I was at? If I get back far enough, there's a fade out to a sprite, to where if I move the camera, the image of it, of that tree, is exact same no matter where I stand or no matter where I tilt the camera. So yeah, they had to cut some corners to make, you know, the immediate, you know, your immediate vicinity look realistic, but then far away, like for example, a lot of those trees in the distance, like right on top of my head, all those trees back there look exactly the same from far away, but when you get close up, you know, they turn into more realistic look. Which is interesting, because from far away, the textures on the rocks are the same textures that they are from close up. Which, I mean, but enough harping on the graphics. It's weird, because it didn't really become apparent until, like, I was never really a graphics person. I mean, if a Nintendo game, you know, I'm a Nintendo gamer. If you're a Nintendo gamer, you're probably inherently not a graphics person. Or just, you know. But, that's not to say that if I see a game that looks graphically, you know, nice to look at, like this game on a Nintendo console, you know, that I'll be turned off by it. Like, obviously this game looks awesome, and it's an awesome game in and of itself, And, like, if it's an awesome game and it has awesome graphics, then, whoa, we got a tyrant here. A level 11 tyrant. If it's an awesome game and it also has awesome graphics, then that's great. But, actually, interestingly enough, this game, well, I guess you could consider Zelda and, like, Metroid games, at least the more realistic-looking Zelda-looking games, are, well, just Nintendo's, I wouldn't say, they're no stranger to realistic-looking games, but it is, it's refreshing to see them at least try to tackle more realistic-looking games every once in a while, which is why it's, you know, it's a, and technically this game wasn't made by Nintendo. Nintendo did, you know, practically take over Monolith Soft, so that's why, you know, that's why, you know, Xenoblade is their exclusive franchise. But and they did work on Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wilds, specifically the open world aspect, because Monolith Soft is just like awesome at making open world games, story-based open world games, RPGs, so Japanese RPGs to be specific, but like prime example, Xenoblade Chronicles X is a Wii U game whose world is many times bigger than many you know, like other open world games in the you know American or just, you know, Western RPGs. You know, Japan or most Japanese RPGs are rarely open world, and this kind of game from a Japanese developer is a very just refreshing kind of game. And Monolith Soft, Soft is probably one of the few developers to excel at that. Out of, especially for the Wii U. Like I said, the Wii U is massively underpowered in comparison to the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One, and it was still able to pump out a game like this. Which, you know, graphically is not necessarily, like, if you were to compare it to another, you know, an Xbox One, PS4 game, it's obviously, you know, not up to par with their graphic, you know, with their games, but, you know, it does make it more impressive. It's more impressive when you see a game like this on a console that's, like, less, I don't know if it's less than half the power of the, or I don't even think the Wii U is half the power of, half or less than half of the power of the, you know, at least the Xbox One. But, because the Switch is, you know, not on par, obviously not on par with the Xbox One. It's barely, you know, breaching that line. It's like a couple, you know, pegs under an Xbox One. I don't know. I'm not exactly 100% sure how far below the Xbox One it is from the Xbox One, but it's definitely, you know, a whole lot closer than the Wii U is. And the Wii U was able to pump out a game that looks pretty too good to be on the Wii U. Like, if they were to put this on an Xbox One or PS4, it would obviously look a lot better. But, maybe, I don't know. But, the fact that it looks, like, I've even seen a lot of people say that this game looks too good to be on the Wii U. But it's on the Wii U, which means, Just, I think Nintendo, they missed some opportunities with the Wii U, in my opinion. It's just, where am I going? Can I make it out from under here? Because I am supposed to be going that way, but the gate to the, and I could be fast traveling, but I've taken the hard way, hard route. But yeah, I am going the right way on foot. So anyway, yeah, it's okay. Yeah, I'm gonna stop boring you guys and actually go to the administrative district. I said district. There's no fast travel point around there. Oh, it's right in front. Great tower. Here we go. We got quite a few new missions to do in the area. Let me see. Yeah. Oh. Wait. Oh, can I not? Oh, I just have to go to the door. Well, we're about to run into a cutscene. That was me turning off my lights. It was the second option. It would be the latter. Your? What does that mean? Long-time resident. That's why we brought him back. Yes, we just said that, asshole. I'd like to request permission for him to stay in New LA. Ass cave, I mean. We can't allow just anyone to waltz into our city on the ring. How much do we know about? We know enough. You really don't know anything, honestly. He just happened upon your thing and you just trusted him. I feel like this is no spoiler because he basically becomes a party member of yours, so there's really no suspicion, and basically he doesn't really contribute to much of the story anymore. You know, there are a couple other I think the only thing you get more of him is like an affinity mission, maybe. But so it wasn't the core for that. What was I saying? I feel like if they make a sequel to this game, and I think they are because of something that goes on later, I feel like he might secretly be a bad guy. I don't know. Or at least not so trustworthy character. I don't know. I just have that crawling suspicion. Thank God it wasn't that cool. This situation could have been a lot worse. The LC archives contain nearly every published work in mankind's history. It's not like it's just a bunch of. And it was all just scrapped. It was the Library of Congress that they destroyed in that life hold pod. We do have parity data for the archives. We know which unit was lost, so hopefully we can find some interest. Yeah. I guess it would be if the whole human race was destroyed. Anyway, it wouldn't really matter, but it would be kind of, a bummer to have been, just to have all your, have all the world's history just wiped. Although, it's not like it couldn't be rewritten or something like that, based on memory. I wouldn't say that necessarily means it's confirmed, but, you know. So either it's one hell of a coincidence or two witnesses are enough for at least perceived confirmation. Boom. Nah. So, none of us would be here talking in the first place. You got a point. Yeah, he already knew that. That was kind of a unnecessary, you know, unnecessary dialogue right there. Before it is too late. Yeah, the clock is always well, I'm not gonna actually. I think that I think that part of the story is explored in the next chapter. Not entirely sure, because I think I my next story mission requires me to explore the next continent. Do you know about the Clickpedia? Oh yeah, that's sort of a tedious thing to do, but it does help you get battle points. So I'm gonna skip all this. We still got 14 minutes, 13 minutes. Oh yeah, we can recruit L. He's everyone's favorite character, and he's my like third favorite character. There's like 22 characters or so. I don't know. There's too many characters in this game to like recruit on your party, but that's a good thing, in my opinion. There's about a Fire Emblem amount of characters in this game to recruit on your party. And if you played Fire Emblem, you know how many characters that kind of alludes to. But yeah, as you probably noted with how L speaks, just all of his little soul voices and all of the reactions he has, like his victory lines and just all that stuff. It's hilarious. Or not hilarious, but just very chucklesome a lot. Now, what am I doing? Oh yeah, I guess I should go to the barracks to see what, okay, my barracks. My barracks. What, what requirements I need for the next missions? Or, yeah, for the next story mission. So, Chapter 5 requires me to install a data probe at Oblivious Entrance and complete Renewed Will Affinity Mission. I believe that is a mission for Irina, which may require me to have like one heart of affinity, so I'll have to probably go to Oblivia with her. So I'm gonna let Elma sit tight for a little bit, and I guess I'll keep Lynn. Wait, how are my levels looking? So, Forrest is level 15. Lynn and Elma are both 14, and I was 16. So, I thought Elma would be higher than Lynn, but maybe Lynn's like growth rate is higher than Elma's, which makes. Oh no, I had her on my team for a while, so maybe that's the reason why, or that is the reason why. There's no maybe. But let's recruit Irina. I almost said equip again, like I said like a couple episodes ago. Not Nexus special. Wanna team up? Sure, why not? Forrest Gump. I promise I won't be making that or trying to make that joke every single time. Let's swap out. Actually, well, yeah, Lin's rank is lower than Elma's, so I'm trying to keep both Elma and Lin at a kind of a level rank, because you have to, you need both of these characters to progress every story mission. So I want them to be pretty even going on. I do want to see if I can, because I like Lao. Actually, you know what? I haven't touched Gwyn yet, so let me switch out Lin for Gwyn. Yep, he's still highlighted blue. He's probably going to be like level 2 or something. So if you got anything you could use my help with, I'll be thrilled to lend a hand. Stay sharp out there. Stay sharp. Don't you worry. I have a pretty long sword. Oh yeah, he's the same class as me. Okay, he's level 12. He's not that bad. So let me swap him for swap him for Lin. All right. Now, well, she says, let me check the gamepad. So on the gamepad, whenever you, like I said, when you see those little things on the screen that say a segment in the industrial district or something has been complete or has opened, that means something on your gamepad has been like completed. One of the little segments on your map has been filled in or has been opened. And ones that you haven't done yet that just popped up will be marked with a little thing that says new. And I'm looking for the mission that is required to do, you know, the... Oh, you know what? I think it's in the commercial district. Yeah. Yep, renewed will. Yeah, okay, so I'm gonna... Oh, I haven't even visited the commercial district yet, so I guess I'm going to have to go down there first, because you have to visit the places you can fast travel to first. So since I haven't been down there, I haven't fast traveled, which obviously makes sense. Like, how can you teleport to something you don't know where you're going to? They fell in the water. Oh, well, no, they didn't, because they don't jump. But anyway, let's just make our way to the commercial district. Man, it would be awesome if Link could jump this high. I don't know how big the planet Hyrule exists on is, but if it's the size of Earth, then that's a bummer. Because gravity, man, if Link was as resistant to gravity as this dude is for this world, then there'd be, well, that would be a major cheat for the game. Oh, wait. Segment and Caldros. Well, that is one of the continents, but I can't even go there now, so it doesn't matter. Where am I going? Where am I? I'm going to pinpoint myself on the... Okay, so I got to go this way to find Irina's mission, which it should be right here. Oh, yeah, this is where, like, she's getting, like, harassed or something. They cross a few lines in this game with, you know, political lines in this game. Like, they have addressed some issues in this game. Like, I'm not gonna get all specific, but, like, I'll just name one thing. They address like suicide at pretty deeply in this game. So there's a lot of like deep, pretty like, you know, not political, but just certain things that you wouldn't expect a Nintendo game to address. But anyway, let's start this affinity mission. Now, I can only have three. Okay, well, let me get rid of party. You know what? I'm gonna get rid of Lao, because he's a higher level, and Gwen is, like, you know, a right-hand man to Irina, so, yeah. Although, this is kind of... Yeah, there we go. No, wait. No, I didn't mean to do that. I have to go to confirm changes. I can't push B and then A. Okay. Now we can do this. No specific requirements. Required level 15. I just... Wait, did I get... Oh! I'm an idiot. Okay. I can't use... Okay, I have to go to... I need Elma and Lynn to do this mission. I thought because it involved Irina that I needed Irina, you know, recruited to my team. But I think what happens is you initiate the mission and then you recruit Irina to your team. Except Elma's not here! Well, shit. Lynn's here, though. Let's head out. Yeah, let's go. Yeah, sure, whatever. You already said that, Lynn, basically. Okay, well, we can still keep... No, we can't, because we can only have three people on our team. So, is there a place where I can just pass the time? There's supposed to be. It's just like sitting by a campfire in Zelda, so I'm gonna go tonight because she shouldn't be at her like heart to heart spot. So heart to heart is like each character has like a place that they'll stand at a certain time of the day. Oh hey, Forrest. Yeah, sure, whatever. Each character has a certain place that they go to up to five times at a certain time of day, like morning, evening, afternoon, like that. Not specific number time, but... and what it, you go there and you just, like, just talk to them and, like, you know, learn their personality and stuff. And that gains an... gives you affinity with those characters, so that's called a heart-to-heart mission. So, like if I find, for example, Elma in a random spot that she's normally not in, that's probably a heart-to-heart mission, and I'll give you an affinity boost with that character. So now I can go to that affinity mission. Spot. If this thing would load, which I probably should have fast travel. I think it can fast travel there now. Let me see. No, I keep hitting the wrong thing. Commercial district. There it is. Yeah, I can fast travel there, so I could have conserved a few seconds. I think after I initiate this cutscene, I will end the video. So, it is this way. Oh, I don't think I've seen this cutscene at night. Not that it really changes anything, but it's still nice to see at night. Okay, let's do it. Cafe, bakery, restaurant. The one thing that's like... The lowest textures in this game are definitely the inside of buildings. pathetic. I was actually gonna say that. I just felt like I was pretty sure that was along the lines of what he would say. These two people are really nobody. No. Kill them, please. Elma, you stay out of this. This isn't your business. Oh, man, you're going to get a copyright claim for that. None of these people in this game are real men or women. Is that a spoiler? I don't know. I wish. I don't know. I think I've already done that first one before. Wait and see what happens. No, I mean, just see, I wouldn't leave Arena to do it by herself, so yeah. Although, I'm using the wrong, I'm standing in the complete wrong stance with the equipment I'm holding. Like, I should be holding up the other fist. The dude. Shut your hole. I saw the whole thing, including where you picked a fight that was about to get your teeth kicked in. Now get your skinny little asses back to the barracks. I wanted to see it, but you know, business and all. I mean, it's my job to make sure it doesn't happen. I just can't deal with men like that. Me either. Ask what brings Vandam here. I mean, it's pretty obvious what's the matter. What brings Vandam here? Actually, I was looking for Elma. I knew it!
New mission?
Yeah, some local indigents causing a ruckus over on the grieving plains. It ain't pretty. Lost a few prospectors already.
Aw, man. They're gone. Yeah, they piss me the fuck off. I want to kill some, you know, animals. Wow, that's, yeah. I want to take my anger out on these helpless. They're not helpless, but these freaking creatures that really didn't do anything to me. Although, was it animals? Yeah, I think it is. I think it's like Rexes or something. Oh man, I keep doing that. Yeah, so. She becomes part of your team, and voila, that's the end of this episode. So, yeah. Next episode, we will, you know, go... This guy's just going to walk right through Lynn and Elma. He says. Where was that grunt when you were walking through me? But anyway, yeah, I'm going to, like I said, continue, head out to wherever that was. In the next episode. So yeah, if you'd like what you see here and you'd like to see more videos, don't forget to hit the like button. If you hate what you're seeing, then don't worry, I'll hit the like button or dislike button for you. You don't have to worry about that. But subscribe while you're at it and leave a comment whatever. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Take care and 1, 2, carry on. 3, 4.